Good afternoon, and welcome to this event to present the synthesis report on families, family policy, and the Sustainable Development Goals. My name is Alberto Padova. I'm the chief of the Social Inclusion and Participation Branch in the Department of Economic and Social Affairs. And I'm delighted to moderate this event to launch this very important study. The study looks at the role and contribution of families and family policies in the realization of the 2030 Agenda and specific Sustainable Development Goals. I think that there's a growing consensus about the fundamental role that families and family policies have in the realization of the agenda. But at the same time, I think that sometimes this important contribution is overlooked. And so
what we really hope is to bring to lawmakers, academics, the private sector and civil society representatives with this tool and the full publication of the outcomes, some tools that will allow them to discern what really works to help families in their social role without trying to replace them, which has been a common mistake, or to leave them alone when they deserve that help. We all see today how some changes society has experimented in the last decades. The massive incorporation of women to the labor market, and more generally, the wider range of personal choices in life, and how they have brought very positive consequences like less inequality and more freedom. But at the same time, there are some side effects that families have to bear with as the greater need for care due. Some children, sick, older people, and other vulnerable groups or groups in situation of vulnerability, that is, are left behind precisely because there is freedom. And only strong families are able to cover their needs, because that is precisely what having a family is about. Only strong families can make societies be really inclusive. Only strong families can make it possible to ensure that no one is left behind, which is precisely the main aim of the 2030 Agenda.
Something you'll hear, and I'm sure you'll hear it for the next 12 years or so in family circles, is that across the SDGs, if you look at the goals and targets, family is only mentioned a few times. Family is rarely mentioned in those goals. And reasons why this may be the case could be to do with the politicization of family, but it also could be to do with what I'm talking about when I say moving from where we want to go to how we get there. We've taken a view of the family in our report as a conduit to social change. The family is the fundamental unit of society. It's our smallest social unit. It's the foundation on which we build everything else, all of our social interaction. And in being that, it is the place where we intervene mostly when we want to intervene for children and other dependents, when we want to support labour market access, when we want to encourage health, when we want to lower violence, and so on.
You know, good family policies are, let's say, social policies with a bonus. They provide better human rights protection for members of the family, gender equality, better outcomes in terms of health, education, and so on and so forth, what you have already mentioned. And they also have a spillover impact on the extended family. And so I believe, and I think that a lot of the other member states share my belief, that moving the conversation forward on this issue is very important. And in that respect, research such as you undertaken is key in enabling us to build on evidence that is out there. And I have seen a progress on this topic during the past year at the UN.
The privilege of observing from the side the process of it and be part of some of the conversations. And it really is a fantastic study and a brave study, because of what the representative from Hungary was saying. It's a conversation that needs to be had. So it's a fantastic first step. Each of the studies could be a whole publication in itself and much more. So I hope this is really only the beginning of bringing practical ideas and bring in the how to achieve this very complicated and colorful conversation that are the SDGs. And I think so SOS Children's Villages works with children without parental care and at risk of losing it, so with families at risk of breaking down. So our perspective into the family is from, and is what I want to bring here today, is say the same just from the other side of the coin, is not to prove how beneficial investing in family policies can be, but how negative the consequences are if these family policies are not put in place and if families are not supported. And that is negative for the child, and that's for the society as a whole.